high school and going into college, I felt I was a young man who knew what was right from wrong. I knew that lust was wrong. I knew that looking upon another woman with lust was wrong. I knew that getting close to a situation that would cause me to stumble was wrong. But at that point in my life, I'd never really been tempted anyway. The very first thing that came my way as a temptation was just an email that was sent to me with a nude picture. And then after that, it was a link to a pornographic site. Over time, as I was in my marriage, years and years into it, I didn't realize that the more I was surrounding myself, not with those things, and I didn't have them often, but when they came up, I didn't even think of them as an attack. I just thought, this is just normal living. And then when I started having relationships with people on the job, and then maybe a little flirtatious conversation, either with a client or a coworker, again, I didn't realize that it was moving towards something that I didn't see coming that would be a disaster. And so we talk about a slippery slope. Well, it was slippery, but I couldn't tell I was even slipping because I didn't see that I was doing anything wrong. And it took about 10 years from the first time that I can tell you that I took the first action toward lust, which was simply looking a little too long. It took 10 years from that first time that I found myself going to a strip club. And I'm sitting in a strip club all of a sudden wondering, what am I doing here? But then I thought, well, you know what? I don't really see anything wrong with this strip club. But after that, after being to the strip clubs for long enough, I actually would get phone numbers from the girls that were actually working at the clubs. And then I would hang out with them and talk to them, make out with them and kiss them, which made it okay then for me to move to that next level, at least in my journey, for allowing myself to be caught in an affair with a woman. I think I was so desensitized that I didn't even see that I was doing anything wrong because, number one, there was no vengeance coming towards me from God. I wasn't getting corrected. I was just being allowed to do these things that I had lost my standards. And I finally realized something's wrong because now I'm a man who's cheating. Never thought I'd be a man who's cheating. Here I am unfaithful. I've taken something that's not mine and now I'm lying about it. And it was one of these wake-up calls and I thought, well, I gotta turn around. But I didn't confess it to anybody. I didn't tell anybody that I was doing it. I just tried to fix myself by stopping it. So I ended up just leaving the marriage altogether. Divorced my first wife, and during that divorce and that separation time, I ended up even doing worse because I was not gonna let anybody know that I was actually falling down in these areas, except for the couple that actually were pretty impressed with it. And those are the friends I didn't need. I needed the friends that were gonna come and say, hey dude, you're losing your soul. It culminated in me spending a couple nights with some prostitutes. And that was a low time for me. It was at that point that I thought, okay, I have hit the bottom here. This is not the man that I should be, and I want to turn my life around. I ended up getting remarried, and in that second marriage, I thought, okay, well, this is going to help me be a real man, you know, just being married. But little did I know, I had taken those same lusts and that same validation that I needed from other women into my second marriage. It wasn't until I was approached by a true friend who came up to me and said, listen, the Lord loves you, and he knows what you've been doing. Repent and turn around. And it was the wake-up call that I needed. Little did I know that God actually was watching, that he was real. And so it was at that point in my life I started to turn around. I was still tempted, however, and even after I was baptized, because I was baptized when I was 35, you do have temptations, Dean, but you don't need to fall to them. So it was by becoming honest and open that I was actually able to now not be at least falling down like I used to.